क्यों नहीं हो? पापा को शादी की ज्यादा जरूरत है।
अरे कोई राज चल रहा है जो पापा को शादी की ज्यादा जरूरत है।
उम्र इतनी हो गई है कि सुहागरात शुरू तो कर देंगे, खत्म नहीं कर पाएंगे।
So Avneet, very exciting to hear about your latest film streaming on ZEE5 Global. Now, obviously, when it comes to the web and it comes to releases, I think there seems to be this affinity that you have for the sort of romantic comedy space. Of course, I'm sure consciously aapne ye decision nahi liya, but what gives you so much joy in exploring such a fun and a delightful genre, so to speak?
So, talking about this itself, it is a rom-com, but it's also a family comedy. So, you can actually sit with your family, you can all watch together on TV, and that's what I wanted to do. I wanted to be a part of something that the family, like families can watch together and they can all laugh because they can make memories out of it, I feel, and to be working with amazing writer like Raaj Shaandaliyaa. So he has delivered such amazing movies in the past, like Dream Girl, Dream Girl 1, Dream Girl 2. So I wanted to be a part of that, in that space, in that genre.
Now, I think it's very nice as well because there's a bit of a Punjabi connection going on here. I think in the casting, of course, Supriya ma'am is also half Punjabi. Annu Kapoor sir is Punjabi. Sunny is Punjabi. You're all Punjabi. So I think when you've got so much Punjabiyat in the casting, you know, jab ek familiarity hoti hai, chahe wo culturally ho ya ek similarity ho, how does it make the process a lot easier, especially when it is something like this genre, which is supposed to be fun anyway? Do you think it enhances that experience as well?
Yeah, I think because everyone has a bit of quirkiness in their real life as well. So when they bring it all together and when we actually make something out of it, it's fun. It's entertaining. Even when we were shooting on the set, I did not feel like we were shooting. I felt like, yeah, there is roll camera action happening, but there are things happening before that that people should actually record also. It was so much fun. It was like a family, because obviously, as you said, there's so much Punjabiness involved to everything, and also the fact that Sunny and I also sort of connected a lot because of that. We both are Punjabis, both belong to Punjab, so yeah, I guess that really makes.
And you know, Avneet, because I think your journey has been quite inspiring. Please also, add your inputs as well as I describe your journey. But you began from a very young age, I think on DID, on Dance India Dance. You then went on to do a lot of TV shows. And then obviously recently in Tiku with Sheru, you kind of made your sort of breakthrough in cinema. But I think over the years, because you represent the Aam Janta, right? How much of that do you find it easier because you've lived that life as a common person? Do you find that easier to bring out that essence, especially when working on a film like this as well?
See, there in my real life, I am a very simple and a very normal sort of person. I enjoy that part of my life. I have come from that part of my life. Never in my wildest dream did I ever think that I would be here. Working as an actor, sitting in a flat and meeting such amazing people, meeting such big celebrities, or working with amazing directors. I belong to a really small city called Jalandhar, and I know I have taken that with me always, and I do not want to leave that. I feel that really gives the realness to each character, and I never want to let go of that as a person also, as Avneet also. I will never let go of my roots, basically. So I think that is the reason why it's really easy for me, and I can actually relate to these characters because I know where they come from, I know their journeys, and I can completely relate to that.
And I think from one benchmark to another, I mean, recently you also became, I think, the youngest actress in Cannes to launch her poster there. So congratulations on that. But I think for you again, you know, like you said, again, dreams and not expected. But, you know, when you are faced with circumstances like that, Avneet, that exposure to, because see, Khan is not just about Hamara Indian cinema. Of course, it's like a world, it's a world platform for cinema generally. Okay. So how much input does that have on you as an artist in terms of understanding the way cinema works as a larger entity as well?
So this was my first exposure to that, for sure. And it was magical. I was blown away. I have all watched movies, or we watched international cinema. But when it actually, when you actually get involved into it, when you actually feel like a part of it, now that is a completely different thing. And also the fact that you actually are representing your country there, that was like a huge deal for me. And I was very nervous at that time. So when it just, I felt like I was in a cocoon somewhere when I was still, but till I was doing like Bollywood or Hindi cinema. But when I actually went to Cannes, and when I realized, you know, there's a huge market there, there are so many more opportunities that waiting to be explored. That is the moment I felt like, yeah, you know, now I need to be a little more serious. It's my country that we're talking about, and I'm going to be the youngest actress who's going to, Indian actress to walk the red carpet at Cannes. I want justify that somehow. I wanted to be a part of that world also. I think it was mad throughout. I was crazy nervous, but when I walked the red carpet, I was very excited. I was just waving at the camera. I was giving flying kisses and all of that. There was a huge moment for me, but I wanted to show that I belonged there, that I was a part of something like that.
Sure. Now, I think it's also quite fascinating, because I think Luv Ki Arrange Marriage also not just exceeds the sort of paradigms of finding love at a later stage in your life, and like you said, being a family drama, but I think that Indian cinema has always, even Indian television, has always had this fascination for arranged marriages. You know, like, I think even in the West, we've been stereotyped to no extent when it comes to arranged marriages, when it comes to sirf shaadi is like the biggest norm, or agar wo hasil kar liya to phir, you know, you've reached the pinnacle of life. Oh, I mean, it's a bit of a heavy question in terms of introspecting, but why do you think that this has been an ongoing trope? And surely there is a lot more to us as Indians in terms of just more than shaadi. And do you think that we are kind of like breaking down those stereotypes now in terms of just limiting ourselves to weddings and all of that?
Definitely. I feel like this movie itself is breaking a stereotype. There's an amazing message that is beautiful. And if we talk about this generation, I feel like we are, there's definitely a transition that is happening, right? Like, people want to live their individual lives, and they want to do more. They are focused more on work. And I have seen that completely if you talk about this generation. So I have definitely seen a change. But yeah, there's also definitely this arranged marriage ka, you know, cheese ki aapko arranged marriage hi karni hai. Agar aapne arranged marriage nahi ki, to pata nahi ho payega fir. So family should be definitely understanding this, I feel. That. And they are actually, there is definitely a transition that is happening. People are putting their work ahead, their work more. So, yeah, I think, yeah.
And you know what's really interesting as well, Avneet, in your filmography, is that I feel like there's always been this strength associated with the projects that you've done, especially on the cinema front. I believe you had a small role in Mardaani as well. You were in Mardaani, which again was so strong about talking about, you know, a woman fighting back, you know, the darkness and the evils of society. Tiku, which was like your first film in terms of getting a prominent lead role. That obviously was backed by someone like Kangana, who doesn't even need an introduction. We all know the sort of, repertoire that she holds. And in Luv Ki Arrange Marriage, you have someone like Supriya Pathak, who is, again, someone who is such a formidable force of talent. I think whilst working with such women and working with such heavy content, to what extent has that also had a bit of an impact on your psyche as well, in terms of strength, in terms of resilience, and not letting, you know, evils of the world sort of bog you down, so to speak?
Okay, I would like to say that, see, I have been working in this industry since I was 7. I have seen a lot of things. It's been, I think, 14 years now that I've been in this industry. And it has taught me a lot about life as well. So when I actually do work with certain people, I get to learn so much, definitely. But I feel like I am at that level of, I think, deepness, I feel. So I can sort of somehow manage to grasp all that. And I feel somewhere I can relate to that at the same time, because I have experienced, there are so many experiences in my life that I feel like I should literally like write a book about right now, this moment itself. But many years ahead, that there are so many years ahead also. So yeah, if you're talking about the darkness or the deepness or the reality of it all, I sort of can relate to it. I have seen a lot. My family and me, we have been through so many struggles of our own in our life as well to come here. So yeah, and I love being a part of something like that. So when we actually did Mardaani, and when I talked with when I spoke to Kangana ma'am for the first time, I have always been an admirer. She has inspired so many people, so many women especially. So yeah, I think I'm grateful that I got along with all these people, and I somehow could relate to Kangana ma'am also as well, because she has also come out from this, and she was not from this industry, she was an outsider herself. So the struggles that she has also faced in her life, I could somehow relate to that also when we had a... So yeah, I think it feels amazing when you're working with such amazing people like this, and you get to learn so much. And I just hope that this learning never ends for me.
But also, you know, if I may say so, Avneet, you're quite young. I mean, you know, you're very young. And the way you, like you said, you've been in this industry for a very long time. And I think jab aap chote hote ho aur aap is industry mein kaam karte ho, and I've had a lot of conversations with like actors like Avika Gaur, who have obviously begun in this industry from a very young age. You know, there's a sense of them growing up very quickly. You know, wo jo ek masoomiyat, ek bachpana jo hoti hai aapki, I think somehow it also affects that. How would you be able to relate with that as well? The fact that, you know, growing up in this industry, because you're playing such mature roles and being part of such mature projects, do you think that has also made you grow up a lot quicker?
I feel I could not... relate to it more. I feel like that's completely true. I mean, but at the same time, I own it also. I feel I own it very confidently. I grew up too fast, I feel, but at the same time, that has taught me a lot. I personally feel it's great when you start young and you have already established yourself. Yeah, there are responsibilities. There come a lot of things in the middle of it. But it feels great when you are at such a young age and you have sort of established yourself. You have made a name for yourself in this industry, because that's always going to be in your favor. I feel like that has been in my favor as well. I do miss out on some of the things in my life, maybe some memories from school years or college years or something, but that has given me a lot in my life, so I do not and will not complain about it. I love my life for sure.
Okay, on a final note, because I'm being told to wrap up, you know, like, I just to bring it back to the first question I asked, you know, about it, of course, being a romantic comedy, Luv Ki Arrange Marriage, but it's also a family drama. But I think, Avneet, now that, you know, you have established your presence, you know, you're making waves slowly and slowly in this very overcrowded industry and this very crazy industry that is the film industry. What sort of projects and what sort of characters are you yearning to play? And, you know, at a stage like this, where obviously everything is so social media driven, it's all so hype driven, how do you hope to either, number one, step up to that, or do you kind of, are you okay with taking your own time in sort of making that breach?
I feel for me, I have always believed that slow and steady wins the race. So I have been working since a very long time, and there has been, I've been growing over the years, and I've been growing slowly but steadily. So I want to do that. I don't want to be that person who just sees fame all of a sudden and then goes silent completely the next year. I don't want to be part of something like that. I want to be a part of this industry for the longest time. I love it with all my heart. And so there is no strategy. I've never come up with like a strategy or PR strategy or something. Even when I started really early, all these social media, Instagram, TikTok, everything, I did it all by myself. There was no strategy behind it. I felt like doing it. I felt that I had a platform that I could show my talent on. So I did. And people started relating to it. People started loving me for who I am. And I think that is something that I will always believe. And yeah, I hope that answers your question.
No, that definitely does. But thank you so much. Thank you so much, Avneet. It's been so wonderful to chat with you. And I think it's so great to see such fantastic new talents emerging. And I think it makes us very reassured that, you know, it's not just the same actors who are casted, that there are other good talents in this industry also that we can also admire and support and encourage as well. So wishing you all the very best for Luv Ki Arrange Marriage on Z5 Global, and cannot wait to catch up with you super soon. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Yeah, absolutely. Take care, Anuj.
Thank you. Bye, everyone.